when we think about what all of us went through during the pandemic and afterwards, was a shortage of goods, and the most persistent shortage of goods wasn't toilet paper and it wasn't mayonnaise, it was semiconductors. And that meant we had a shortage of computers. It meant that we had difficulty getting the phones that we wanted. It meant that automobiles and the manufacture of those things and lots of other things were impossible worldwide because the supply of chips, of all kinds of chips, was really bottled up and wasn't a global supply. And so we see globally, not just in the U.S., in Japan, we expect to see in Europe, and certainly in the U.S. in the forefront of this, is encouraging these suppliers to build in America and not just Taiwan. And what that means is that the whole world will have access to the chips that they want when these foundries get built. And it's not just Taiwan Semiconductor, and it's not Samsung, as you mentioned. It's also Global Foundries. It's also Micron. You should see what Intel is doing in Columbus, Ohio, of all places. There's incredible developments going on with building these foundries, and some things are going to do really well and other things are going to do just okay. But what we're going to have is a global distributed supply of semiconductors, which is going to make our global economy more predictable, which is good for everybody.
What about Samsung? So who all become the key players of this future plan of advancing technology?
Well, we certainly look, it's the companies that are the best at making semiconductors, right? So when we know it's going to be the companies like the manufacturers, which we're talking about right now, right? TSMC, the most important of them all, but Intel and their foundries, Micron, Global Foundries as well, and Samsung. But we also know it's going to be a lot of the suppliers of that. So we would expect companies like ASML, of course, to be producing the machines, Applied Materials to be producing the machines that make those chips. And then you can go right on down the product lines of all the other companies that are making it. But then throw into that, right, the companies that are making the products that support the data centers, whether it's Oracle, which, full disclosure, I own shares of Oracle, but in my personal account. Mm-hmm. But you see companies like Oracle and Amazon and Google building up data centers, Microsoft, Facebook, and beyond that. Let's go deeper than that. Let's look at the construction jobs that are going to happen here in the United States as a result of this. And high-end construction, when we can see the companies that are doing so well in doing the best kinds, the most difficult kinds of construction for these kind of plants that have never been
done
before.
But isn't there a shortage of labor?
The companies that make the air conditioning, the companies that are doing everything that makes all these things work are going to see work in the U.S., and that's going to be good for U.S. workers of all types.